Now, today's video hits a little close to home. We're going to talk about something that, you know, happens to some people more than others. Brain farts. Brain farts. I get brain farts all the time. Like, trying to string sentences together sometimes is a real struggle. Thank God that I have editors. I love you guys because you make me seem somewhat sane. I mean, still insane, but not as insane as what I am. So I thought, I'm going to make myself feel a little bit better. I'm going to see other people's brain farts to make me feel better about my brain farts. Did I say farts too many times? Am I going to get demonetized? Does farts get demonetized? My head hurts already. Welcome. The elevator doors opened up and a guy walked in the elevator. Ooh, the plot thickens. It was just me and him in there. Ooh, the scene. It's getting romantic. And he said, I love you. What? And I'm not rude, so I said, I love you too. He gave me a weird look and pointed at his Bluetooth. Hey, maybe this guy needed a little love and maybe he was having a bad day. You were just trying to cheer him up. Next minute, you're embarrassed because you've literally just told some random stranger that you love him. I'm legitimately getting secondhand embarrassment. Like, it feels absolutely terrible. I feel like that's the kind of situation whether you're the person who said I love you or the person that I said I love you to, you're gonna be embarrassed. That's a brain fart and a half thinking that somebody, some random stranger of all people is gonna be saying I love you. I don't know, maybe it was love at first sight. He looked at you and was like, damn, I've gotta confess my feelings. Did you go to the liquid zoo? The liquid zoo, 100%. This is exactly what I would do. Where you can walk inside, you mean aquarium, yes. It's a fucking aquarium, not a liquid zoo. Listen, if you can't think of the word aquarium, liquid zoo is kind of, you know, I can't even judge these people because my editors, they'll know. I'm not the brightest in the bunch. Sometimes when I can't think of a word, I think of descriptive words about that word to try and figure out what the word is and hope that Google will figure it out for me. Google is pretty much my brain at this point. So liquid zoo kind of makes sense. I do know what the word aquarium is, but if I didn't, liquid zoo kind of fits. Kind of is cooler, not gonna lie. I had to go to a library to pay a fee and I was practicing in the car between I have to pay a fine and I have to pay a fee. You were practicing? Listen, it's an anxiety thing. Sometimes when you have something to say and you're a little bit nervous about the situation, you repeat in your head or in the car or when no one's looking what you actually have to say. So I have to pay a fine, I have to pay a fee. One more time, I have to pay a fine, I have to pay a fee. And I walked in and firmly stated, I have to pee. As I was firmly saying I have to pee, I slapped a $5 bill on the counter when the fee was actually only 10 cents, literally 10 cents, $5. I just spat everywhere, terrible. Slapped it on the counter. This was like 3 years ago and I still haven't been back. Listen, if that was my school library, if that was my local library, I would never ever return. The embarrassment is just too much. Even if the person who was there has moved on with their life, maybe they've gotten another job, it doesn't matter. The room knows, everyone knows. Like, oh, I'm getting secondhand embarrassment. I'm not even the person it's happening to and I feel the pain. I have to pee. My friend was driving and we were almost past our turn off. So I tried to say quick and fast at the same time. And I ended up screaming quack. Fast and quick, quack. Quick and fast, quack. I'm trying to get it through my head. Which ended up with him judging me very hard and missing the turn. How dare your friend judge you like that? You were just trying to say quick. You were just trying to say fast. But you ended up saying quack instead. Quack, quack. I'm picturing myself being that person. Was meant to say, oh crap, I left my phone in the car. What I almost said was, oh no, I left my cone in my far. Phone, car, cone, far. But what I actually said was, my fart cone. How embarrassing. You are going to live with that haunting you for the rest of your damn life. I'm sorry. I shouldn't be laughing at these people. I know that they're embarrassed. I'm sorry. Brain farts are normal. I always have brain farts. I've had about 10 brain farts since we started this video. I'm having a brain fart right now. Am I okay? What's going on? One time I went to hand somebody a bowl of hot soup and my brain tried to say, careful, it's hot and here's your soup. So instead I blurted out, careful, it's soup. You've got to be careful. Soup is quite dangerous. One, it can judge you and that's the worst thing of all. Very scary. I just tried to say Justin Timberlake out loud. Out loud. I just tried to say Justin Timberlake out loud. Out loud. But it came out as Jimba Timba. It's going down. I'm Jimba Timbo. Oh God, that's actually quite catchy, isn't it? I just had a brain fart just then. What conversation are you having where you like need to bring up Justin Timberlake and then you end up saying Jimba Timba? This person tried to say, are you guys all good and are you guys all okay? And instead ended up saying, are you guys all gay? Simple yet effective. Are you guys all good? Are you guys all okay? Are you guys gay? Wait, what? Wasn't what I meant, but all right, moving on. Meant to say, hold on for a second and give me a minute to a customer and it came out as, hold me for a second. That is one of the worst mixtures you could have. Like customers like, we're just at a McDonald's. Imagine ordering a cheeseburger and then they go, hold me for a second. Wait, what? We barely know each other. You just asked me if I wanted extra ketchup on my burger. I accidentally tripped an old lady, meant to say, I'm so fucking sorry and are you okay? What came out was, are you fucking sorry? Okay, you shouldn't be swearing at an old lady in the first place. I'm so sorry. Are you okay? Are you fucking Sorry?
You got in between me and my foot, me and my walkway. You think you own these streets?
I don't know where I'm coming from with this. I just turn into a different person when I embody these people.
Oh, you would just feel like such a terrible person.
I had a patient that had to drink a really gross medication. She downed it and my brain was caught between like a champ and you're a trooper. What came out of my mouth was, you're a tramp. We laughed about that for weeks. I'm laughing about it for weeks too. You'll find me 3 years down the track still laughing about this, Holly. Hilarious. I once attempted to offer a table a sample of our meatball special, which was made up of 8 pork balls.
Pork balls. 8 pork balls.
I was describing flavors and my own opinions, but instead of being a normal effing person, I just asked, would you like to taste my balls? So that was a great hour and a half. I feel like that's a nice little icebreaker. I feel like, you know, people with a little bit of sense of humor is gonna giggle at that. They're gonna enjoy that. Would you like to taste my balls? My spicy meatballs. My spicy pork balls. I remember being 17 and hungover working at a pool shack and said to a customer, hi, how can you help me? She cracked up laughing and said there probably wasn't much she could do. Listen, when you're hungover and you gotta work the next day, I've done it before. It's rough. Usually it's, hello, how can I help you? Today it's, how can you help me? Please end my suffering. Get me a Gatorade or something. I don't know, a glass of water, maybe some hangover food, greasy food, please. The cashier at Carl's Jr. asked if my order on the screen was correct. Fresh out of court, I responded, yes, Your Honor. I think I need a vacation. I think you need a vacation also. Sometimes work, it consumes your life. Me more than anyone knows that. Maybe if I walked up to a cashier and was like, subscribe to my channel or welcome back guys or yeet. Usually that's kind of what I say in videos. I emailed my professor and meant to say, I am worried. I don't understand some material on our next test, but I accidentally sent this. Professor Allen, I am worried. That's it. One sentence. I am worried. The poor professor's probably worried about your mental health and you're over here just accidentally clicking buttons that you shouldn't be. Brain farts, man. I've done that before on like Discord and stuff. When you've half sent a message and you're like halfway through the paragraph and then you accidentally press send, and you're like, oh no, I sound like an idiot. And I can't take it back. That's what I hate about messages. You can't take them back. You're worried about the test? I think Professor Allen is worried about you, mate. I couldn't remember the word tumbleweed. And the search results are rolling hay, wind garbage, sticks and trash balled up. Oh God, it's so funny because I just relate. Sticks and trash balled up. It's so funny because I do it all the time. Sticks horses game to win princess. Wait, what? I forgot the word for joust. Medieval duel game. Medieval fight club game. I forgot the word reindeer today, so I describe them as Christmas llamas. Christmas llamas. I mean, I would say more like Christmas deer is a reindeer. I mean, is a reindeer an actual animal? I'm confused. I was texting my sister and I completely forgot the word for butchery. English one again. A meat buying place is open today. I wonder if the sister actually noticed, or did they just notice later? They're like, I really couldn't figure out the word for a butcher, so I just said the meat buying places. The places that you buy meat. I don't know. Oh God, this is hurting my brain. It's actually bringing me great joy knowing that other people suffer this as well. Like, I'm not alone, guys. I'm not alone. Just describe something that looked like a vest as a fabric hot dog because I forgot the word for vest. A fabric hot dog. I mean, kind of low-key makes sense. Not really, though. A fabric hot dog. Forgot the word tissue, so I asked Royce for a sneeze paper. Not gonna lie, I kind of dig sneeze paper over tissue. Excuse me, sir, could you please pass me some of that sneeze paper? Sounds so professional, don't you think? It doesn't at all, but like, come on. Sneeze paper? Come on, give me some sneeze paper real quick. I've been googling sack rat for half an hour because I forgot the word kangaroo. Like, I just don't think that matches, but it just sounds so funny. The national animal for Australia is a sack rat. My dad forgot the word for socks, so he goes, you know, gloves for your feet. Kind of an accurate representation. Gloves for your feet. I stand with this man. I stand with this dad. Gloves for your feet. Makes more sense. One of those days where I forgot the word for candy corn. Three color Halloween thing. The fact that candy corn even came up, like, I'm actually, bravo Google. Sometimes Google literally just knows better than a normal human brain. Computers are smarter than us. They're gonna overtake the world one day. I forgot the word for wall and described it as a concrete fence. But I feel like there is concrete fences that aren't walls, I guess. I don't know. This is a concrete wall. Is it a concrete fence? Now I'm just confused. I've read so many of these that I'm just getting confused now. So I forgot the word for scarf and asked my mother to make me a knitted neck bracelet. I can't say anything. I can't judge them. The fact that you can think a knitted neck bracelet for the word scarf is quite smart in my opinion. I think these people are quite intelligent. Just saying. Everyone has occasional memory loss, but only intelligent people can find other words for those things that they've forgotten. My mum forgot the word for pumpkin, so in Chinese, she called it Halloween melon. It low-key is kind of like a Halloween melon. I forgot the word for budget, and I just called it a money diet. Listen, man, money diet sounds way cooler than budget ever does. Budget sounds like adulting. Money diet sounds cool as shit. I went to say thanks dude and cheers lad to a waiter once and it came out thanks dad. What is the way to do in that situation? Hopefully they're a really funny person. They're like, son, I'm so proud of you.
Oh god, I would be thinking about that for the rest of my life. You know when you accidentally call a teacher mum or dad? Like,
oh no.
I'm still thinking about it now. It happened to me when I'm a kid and look, it's still haunting me and everything that I do.
God damn, it hurts my soul.
Brain cell one, say have a nice day. Brain cell two, nah, say have a good one. Mouth, have guys done.
Have guys done.
I need a new girlfriend. Mine is broken. I knew that already. Do you like passagility?
What is it? Passagility?
What the fuck is that?
Paschetti.
What?
Lol, I don't know how to spell it.
Spaghetti? Wait, what? How were they pronouncing this food? Did they think that there was like a silent P and A?
I mean, listen, your girlfriend, she might actually be broken. She might actually have to go to the doctor. Can you please send her to the doctor?
Well, I'm walking out of today's video feeling a little bit smarter and a little less alone.
I sounded so dumb when I said that. A little bit smart. I'm intelligent. Hello.
But if you like this video, make sure you do subscribe to the channel. Make sure you give it a huge thumbs up. And if you brain fart, don't worry, you ain't alone.
You ain't alone. Yeet.